Welcome to Blooming Wildwood Homestead. I'm so glad to have you back with me today, and I wanted to spend some time having a conversation about different skills that you can learn and things that you can begin developing and experimenting with while you're living in an urban location. So for many of you, you might have the dream of moving to the country, being able to have wide, expansive land, being able to do all of the things that you've always dreamed of, whether it's raising animals, having a garden, raising all of your own food, whatever it might be, you're probably dreaming about that and wondering what you can be doing if you aren't able to move to such a location at this particular point in time. For the past 14 to 15 years, I have been living in town in various types of circumstances. My first home was a place where I was renting basically a couple of rooms, more like an apartment sort of situation. And at that particular point, I was able to try my hand at some container gardening. Then I moved to a second location where I was renting, and I started doing some raised beds and growing my food that way. I also continued to have some containers and had a couple of fruit trees that I was able to put in at that particular property as well. And then my last home was also in the city, and I didn't have a huge backyard, but I knew that I wanted to continue to work on learning how to grow my own food and developing out some of my skills. And I want to encourage you today that you can do the same thing. No matter where you're at, no matter what your situation is, you have the ability to do that. And I want you to be encouraged to give it a try, even if it's not your ultimate final destination and the thing that you're looking forward to doing in the end. While I was at these different locations, I learned a wide variety of skills that I was able to transfer over into each different area where I lived. And those skills I'm also going to be able to use here on the country homestead as well, and will continue to develop the skills that I started. One of the first things that I learned how to do was what I could actually grow in pots and how much people limit themselves by not thinking outside of the box and not considering container gardening and different things that you can do as far as that goes. So at all of my locations, I've always had herbs in containers. At my last two locations, I started experimenting with some fruit as well. I've had blueberries in containers, kind of the big barrels. I've done rhubarb in a barrel, and all of those things were really successful and helped me to learn how I could best take care of the plant in that type of environment, as well as providing some wonderful produce while I was living in town. Another skill that I was able to learn and develop was how to take care of fruit trees and how to prune fruit trees. Now, I am by no means claiming to be an expert. I still have so much to learn in that area. However, by starting somewhere, I've already begun to develop some skills. I was able to do the espalier type pruning and have trees that were shaped in the espalier way at my last location, and it really helped me to learn what it meant to shape a tree and how important that is and how important pruning is when it comes to providing that shape and that foundation for the tree, and also helped me to learn about different kinds of apple varieties and how they fruit in different ways and how that can affect the way that I'm pruning and the way that I'm working with that tree. And so those are some skills that I've begun to develop, and I'm hoping to transfer over to my work here, and we'll be able to continue growing in that area. Another thing that I was able to do was learn how to maximize a small space and maximize production in a small area, particularly with my strawberries and my raspberries. I was able to put my strawberries underneath my espalier apple trees, which really maximized that space next to my fence where I couldn't really put anything else. I've been able to get lots of great production off both the trees and the berries. I also put in a small bed of raspberries and learned the importance of taking care of them, pruning them, and just being able to cultivate them in a way that would help them to be really productive as well. Another thing, another skill that I've been working on is learning how to compost. This is again something that I'm still really working on developing. I've only done it in small amounts, and I definitely have learned a few things that do not work, and sometimes I think we underestimate the power of our mistakes. So even though I'm still working on learning how to do it the right way, the mistakes that I've made have really helped me to know what to avoid as I'm trying to compost on a larger scale. Another skill that I've been working on is learning how to do succession planting. With a smaller space, you just don't have as much area to work in, and it's really, really important to learn how to do succession planting so that you don't have everything coming on all at one time and you can extend your season out as far as possible. And that is something that will vary depending on what location you're in, but it doesn't matter where you're at, that's a skill that you can work on learning. The next skill that I've been trying to gain is learning how to extend the growing season by using different kinds of protective materials. So I have tried larger hoop huts. I've done some smaller hoop hut in my last location, and sometimes it's been successful, sometimes it hasn't been successful. So one of the things that I've really learned from that experience is that I have to pay attention to where the sun is in relation to where my garden is and how that changes throughout the fall and the winter, and how for some areas you might not have a lot of options to extend your season all the way through the winter, but you might be able to extend it by a couple of weeks, maybe using a smaller hoop hut on both ends of things. At my last location, I really wanted to have gardening throughout the winter, but I just didn't get the sunlight because of the trees that were behind the alley and the house that was shading on the other side, and it just wasn't light enough to be able to grow year round. But I did learn a few things there that I'm planning to transfer with me to my new location. As I already stated, one of the other things that I've learned through the course of being in many different locations is that sometimes the best learning tool is our mistakes. And when you go into something and you want to do it correctly and you're concerned about doing it correctly, sometimes we can get so worried about that that we don't even try it at all, and then we lose the opportunity to learn something from that experience. So I would encourage you, no matter where you're at, no matter how you can get started, give it a try. Whether you're in an apartment and you want to try your hand at doing some container gardening, or even if you're in a rental or an urban location where you can have a small raised bed, give it a try. See what you can grow. See what works well for you, and take those skills and learn from them so that when you get to that ultimate property that you want to have, you're going to be able to maximize that, both your time and your space. All right, everyone, I hope that this is encouraging to you, and I hope that you will take some time to reflect on what kinds of skills you might be able to learn or maybe develop in the location that you're at before you even have opportunity to go to that dream place that you're hoping to get to farther on down the road. Until next time, bye everyone.